Hi everybody, before we get started with the video, there are three very important things that I have to tell you. Number one, we in no way are trying to promote Coke. Number two, Coke is nothing but shakkar ka pani, and a lot of shakkar is not good for your body. So do not consume Coke in excessive quantities. And third and most importantly, ये जो फैक्ट मैंने तुमको अभी बताया है दैट कोक इज नथिंग बट शक्कर का पानी एंड इट्स बैड फॉर हेल्थ एवरीबडी नोज अबाउट इट बट हैव यू वंडर्ड इन स्पाइट ऑफ दिस ब्रांड मेयरली सेलिंग शुगर्ड वाटर हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल दैट देयर एबल टू जनरेट बिलियन डॉलर प्रॉफिट्स एवरी सिंगल ईयर एंड नॉट जस्ट दैट कोको कोला इज अ कंपनी दैट हैज सर्वाइव्ड फॉर मोर देन 111 ईयर्स विच इंक्लूड्स 7 रेवोल्यूशंस एंड 2 वर्ल्ड वॉर्स द क्वेश्चन इज How is it possible that a company selling sugared water could make $1 billion in spite of having competitors which are much more tastier than Coca-Cola and much more healthier than Coca-Cola? And a simple example of that is the lemonade business in India. And the answer to that is that Coca-Cola deploys a genius marketing strategy because of which Coca-Cola is able to make $1 billion in profits merely by selling sugared water. So if you're here to learn something incredible, Let's do a deep dive and try to understand one of the greatest marketing strategies ever known to mankind, and that is Coca-Cola. In 2005, people, there was this scientist called Reid Montag who conducted a very simple experiment to try and understand as to what exactly is the difference between Coca-Cola and Pepsi and which one was more preferred by people. So he conducted this simple experiment with three iterations. In the first iteration, he placed two bottles, one of Coke and the other of Pepsi, and he took off the label so that people couldn't identify on the outset which one is Coke and which one is Pepsi. So when he called the subjects to come and taste both the colas, he scanned their brains through an fMRI scanner. And the first iteration, when people came and tasted both the colas from the bottles which were not labeled, they were not even able to identify the difference between both the colas. And the fMRI scanner also did not show any significant difference in the reading. So he sends them back and calls them in for a second iteration. This time, he puts the labels back on so that people can identify which one is Coke and which one is Pepsi. This time, when the subjects come and taste Pepsi, nothing happens. But the moment they tasted Coca-Cola, the fMRI scanner showed a significant difference in the reading. That's when Reid Montag thought, maybe there's something to the recipe. So let's send them back and call them in for a third iteration. This time, he swabbed the logos, which meant that the bottle that contained Coca-Cola was now labeled as Pepsi, and the bottle that contained Pepsi was now labeled as Coca-Cola. This time, when the subjects came and tasted the cola from the Pepsi-labeled bottle, nothing happened. But the moment they tasted the cola from the Coca-Cola labeled bottle, the fMRI scanner showed the same significant difference in the reading. And that is when Reid Montag understood that it is not the cola, it's not the bottle, it's not the subjects, it is just the flash of the red color logo of Coca-Cola that made that significant difference in the reading. Now to put that straight, people, in front of the scenes, it's just the 3-second logo flash that made a significant difference in the reading and altered the very perception of people, whereas behind the scenes, it clearly justifies the $1 billion budget that Coca-Cola takes out every single year to establish itself as the brand icon of happiness. Now, people, the question is, what do we exactly mean by brand icon of happiness? So for that, let us try to understand the fundamentals of marketing. So every product, people, has two kinds of values. The first value is the tangible value, which is the real value of the product. And the second value is the perceived value. Now, just to give you a simple example of the same, take for example, a restaurant. Now, when you go to a restaurant, the aroma, the room freshener, the ambience, the lighting is what is going to make up for the perceived value of the product. It is going to enhance your perception of the experience. And the tangible value of the product is how well the food is cooked. So if I serve you rotten chicken in the best restaurant in the world, you're still not going to like it, right? Because the true value of the product is nothing but the product of the tangible value and the perceived value. So if one of them is very bad, then the value of the product goes down. Similarly, if I were to serve you the best food in the world, but then I put dead cockroaches around the table, you're still going to feel disgusted, right? Now the question is, you still have the best food on the table. then it's the cockroaches are not even inside the food. Why do you still not like the experience? And the answer to that is, even though the tangible value of the product is great, the perception of the product has been degraded to such an extent that the experience is completely ruined. So every company needs to make sure that it is able to build great products, hence bringing up tangible value for the product, and it has to make sure that the marketing strategies are so well designed that it is able to enhance the perception of the product in the minds of the people. Now, when it comes to Coca-Cola, the tangible value of the product is nothing but sugar. And by default, scientifically speaking, sugar is bound to give you pleasure. Whereas when it comes to the perception of the product, Coca-Cola does an extraordinary job by associating itself with the emotion of happiness. Now, a classic example of this association with emotion can be seen when Coca-Cola penetrated the Indian population using its remarkable marketing strategy. So to put that straight, when Coca-Cola came to India, they were facing a hard time because they did not know ki aisa kaun sa commercial leke aaye which is going to resonate with the entire country. Because we are such a beautifully complex country ki ek state se dusre state mein jaane par tradition change ho jayega, culture change ho jayega, language change ho jayega, lifestyle bhi change ho jayega. So how does a brand come out with a commercial which is going to resonate with the entire country? And that is when, after doing a deep research, they found this beautiful recipe of something called the game of cricket. Because Coca-Cola, after doing a deep market research, understood that in India, regardless of your religion, caste, race, sex, in the game of cricket, everybody is an Indian and everybody is going to cheer Sachin, Sachin. And guess what? They hired Sachin Tendulkar as their brand ambassador and came out with a beautiful campaign called Coke Ki Khushi, Cricket Ki Khushi. And they came out with a bunch of commercials which portrayed the true essence of the game of cricket. And this is what the commercial looks like.
Tapman 42 degree. Sar par topi nahi, pairon mein chappal nahi. Thos ke liye chiller nahi. जमीन पर घास नहीं, बैट पर रबर नहीं, आंखों पर गॉगल नहीं, पवेलियन पर छत नहीं, तापमान 42 डिग्री और खुशी में कोई कमी नहीं। ये खेल नहीं, इस जमीन की सच्ची खुशी है।
खेलते रहो, खुश रहो।
If you look closely at that commercial, it is not even talking about the product until the last 3 seconds. Because you know what? While good brands sell you products, legendary brands sell you an emotion. And that is the secret behind Coca-Cola's genius marketing strategy. So to put that straight, there are a few lessons that you need to learn as entrepreneur if you want to do the same for your product. Number one, like I said, while good brands sell you their product, legendary brands will always try and sell you an emotion. Number two is, it is okay if you don't talk about specifications. All you have to do is tell a great story. And if you do that, you're going to resonate with your customers more than anybody else. And number three, and most importantly, even if you're selling sugared water, you could still make $1 billion. That's all for today, guys. Have a look at the workbook now. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye. Take care.